Just to let you guys know quickly, we're running a Black Friday sale over on the new merch at refraction.shop with code BF10 at checkout. You can get 10% off all orders until the 4th of December. If you want to get any orders in before Christmas, now is the time to do it. Link in the description. Today we are finally crafting the best sword in Hypixel Skyblock. Dude, Speed Silver got so lucky. He managed to get a handle for like 150 mil before everybody realized how overpowered these new swords are, and everybody wants them. I've been bidding on every handle on the auction house. I've been bid up to like 500 million coins. Finally, I found one that was gonna run out at like 3 or 4 a.m. So there was nobody online to outbid me, and we managed to get one for 444 million coins. This thing costs as much as a legendary drag pet does these days, dude. And that's just one part of making the dang sword. So to get Necron's handle, you need to get an S plus on the new floor, which is quite a feat. You know, you have to do it with all of the secrets and three or fewer deaths, which is quite incredible. Floor 7 has been out for 3 or 4 days, and if you want to have a look on the auction house at how many Necron's handles there are like, oh, there's actually quite a few now. Jeez, people are getting lucky and dropping them, but they cost 35 mil from the chest, and people really want these weapons because they are the best in the game by far. We also need 24 wither catalysts, and we can make it into Necron's blade. At last, I have Necron's blade. I've been trying for so long. Basically, it has 5 variants, I believe. First off, we have Scylla, which gives crit damage, which I guess is kind of like an archer slash pseudo berserk kind of sword. It's a little bit weird. We have Astraea, which is crafted with Jolly Pink Rocks, which is defense, which is kind of like a tanky slash healer sword. We also have Hyperion, which is the mage version of this sword. A lot of people are trying to get me to make Hyperion because it is crazy good. It gives you so much intelligence. It gives you more intelligence based on your catacombs level. It's ridiculous, but I'm not a mage. The final version that we are indeed making is Valkyrie, which gives you strength and damage per catacombs level, 50% extra damage to withers and 60 ferocity. This weapon is nuts, even on its own, even just a left click weapon, okay? But its mage ability or item ability is just daft. To make Valkyrie anyway, we need 8 Diamantes handles. You may have noticed that all of these swords require 8 different items here. These actually drop from the giants in the blood room. So if you rush the blood room, you have a chance of getting these. But at long last, I'm going to have this beautiful weapon, and at last it is mine. In case you were wondering, you can also change your mind, change all of the variants. So if I put Valkyrie and surround it with Laser's Eyes, it will actually turn it into Hyperion, keep all of the stars, enchants, reforges everything. First things first, before I make this item worth more than it already is, because this is worth like 500 million coins already, I am going to go and put stars on it. I need to get somebody to actually 5-star it for me because I don't have enough wither essence. There we go. My beautiful 5-starred Valkyrie already has 2000 gear score. You may have seen Speed Silver's video where he was doing crazy damage with this sword. Well, that was partially due to the bugged Soul Eater. Soul Eater was really, really buggy at the time. Basically, what Soul Eater does is it clones the strength of the mobs you kill and then applies it on your next hit, right? Well, Soul Eater wasn't resetting properly. It would just stack and stack and stack infinitely. People were doing billions of damage. It was really broken, really OP. So that's why Valkyrie was doing so much damage in Speed Silver's video. It's still a really good weapon, but it doesn't do hundreds of millions of damage. Where it really shines are with these 3 scrolls here. What I really like about this weapon is how you can customize it with these scrolls. It has 3 different abilities that you can put on it. One is called Implosion, which will deal 16,270 damage to nearby enemies. Pretty good. It obviously scales in dungeons that can do millions of damage. It's insane. The Shadow Warp, which creates a spatial distortion around you that sucks all enemies into it, and then you can detonate it by right-clicking again, basically like a gravity bomb kind of thing. Finally, we have Wither Shield, which reduces the damage taken by 30% for 5 seconds, grants you an absorption shield that gives 200% of your crit damage as health, and after 5 seconds, 50% of your shields are converted into healing. All 3 of these basically are crazy. It's like, which one do I put on it? They are all so good. Well, the good thing is you can put all 3 on. They combine into a secret 4th ability that is just absolutely wild. I kind of want to try out Implosion first. So if you put that on and do this, bam. We just explode, dude. I hit one enemy for 100k damage, apparently. I probably hit Speev. All right, let's put the next scroll on. I think I want to try out Shadow Warp next. So apparently this creates like a spatial distortion. And if I right click it again, it will detonate it. And finally, we have Wither Shield. So now it will have all three abilities on it and unlock a fourth ability. So if we look now, it has item ability Wither Impact. Teleport 10 blocks ahead of you. Implode, dealing 33k damage to nearby enemies. Applies the Wither Shield scroll ability, reducing damage taken and granting an absorption shield. So there you go. It does all of that just with one right click. It's basically just an AOTE that when you TP through, you blow everything up and you heal a ton of health. This sword is just nuts, man. I've already prepared this, boys. Full on max sword book, tier 7 enchant. It's got everything we need. I'm going to put Dragon Hunter 5 on it as well. And finally, a little bit of a controversial one, but I'm going to put Ultimate Wise 5 on it. This ability costs 250 mana and it's too good to not be able to spam on cooldown. So I'm going to reduce that down to 125. This is what's going on my Valkyrie. That is so hot. I think I have every single enchant there. Fuming's hot potato, but don't worry, man. Don't worry. We need 10 of these, obviously. Get in my basket. Oh, this is always so satisfying to do, man. I haven't done this for so long. Few weapons are actually worth being maxed out like this, but Valkyrie 100% deserves it. We're up to 2200 gear score. We can go further, chat. I also have, obviously, a Dragon Claw that we need to apply to this thing. Bam, Dragon Claw, Fabled Reforge is applied. And finally, the last thing we need for it, a Recombobulator. And we have a fully maxed out Valkyrie, chat. 2544 gear score. It's still less than my Livid Dagger. Let's go do a damage comparison real quick. Maxed out Fable Valkyrie versus maxed out Livid Dagger, chat. Which one will win? You'll find out after I tell you about today's video sponsor, Dashlane. In a world where everything is being done from home and online, all of your private information could be one password away from being breached. That's why I recommend Dashlane. All of your accounts can have their own unique passwords that you don't even have to remember. Its secure autofill feature will mean that accessing your accounts on any platform is only one click away for you and harder than ever for any potential attacker to get into. Dashlane also includes a VPN service to prevent prying eyes from tracking your activity online, as well as dark web monitoring to let you know if your information is being bought and sold illegally. Try Dashlane for free on your first device today at dashlane.com/refraction, and when you want to upgrade to premium, use code refraction for 40% off. Let's try it out. Here it is, the damage test. What are we going to use? First up, we have the good old Gilded Midas. The old faithful, dude. You can't go wrong. 340,000 damage pretty much every single time. Next up, I think we're going to use the Livid Dagger. So Livid Dagger does 320k, actually. That's slightly less than a Midas. And finally, we have the Valkyrie. I want your predictions on how much this is going to do. I've seen a lot of 420ks. You guys are very original. We are going to do 380k. But Ferocity did trigger, so we basically do twice that. All right. Yeah, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. We're basically doing like 780k damage. That's all right, dude. I rate that. It's okay. But where this thing truly shines, I suppose, is the ability. So this poor zombie, dude, he's doomed. Oh my god, I just did 500,000 damage to him. It's just a deadly aspect of the end, pretty much. Pet, you idiot. Oh, I wasn't using an Ender Dragon that entire time. With an Ender Dragon, we do 460k, 520k even. I mean, obviously, the place we want to test it the most is Floor 7. That's really where it's going to shine. All right, so right off the bat, we're in a new dungeon. No blessings, nothing whatsoever. And Speev yoinks that kill from me. Thank you, Speev. I appreciate that, sir. Bam! We do 5.5 million damage right off the bat. I want to try it out for room clearing, though. We can't do it on the first room, dude. Everyone kills everything in the first room. Let's go in here and go... Yeah, that's kind of good. Forget the Shadow Fury, dude. These are my stats in dungeons, by the way, with no blessings. So 8,000 HP, 3K defense, 2,700 strength, 2,000% crit damage, 2,000 intelligence, and 107 ferocity. Here is where we're going to shine, chat. Valkyrie so far is fun. It's amazing for room clearing, but it's nothing insane. If anything, it actually becomes better in the boss fight room, though, because it disables the teleport ability of it because you're not allowed to teleport in these, which means we can just do this and absolutely lay into Necron. Also, we do 50% extra damage to Withers. So yeah, this sword is gonna be nuts in here, man. Just watch this. Watch my chat. Oh Oh my god. Okay, yeah, yeah. Valkyrie is insane, dude. This room makes me realize mage is not the way. Mage is not what I want to do with my life. All right, let's try it out with the tiger pet as well, chap. That's what you all are saying to do, so we're going to use the tiger pet versus Necron here and see what we can do. No way. No way, dude. This sword is actually busted. I think the tiger pet might actually be kind of viable. Something I do want to experiment with is maybe getting like 100% attack speed as well as 100 ferocity. Because I'm not going to lie, I miss my 100% attack speed from the livid dagger. That is crazy. We have 215 ferocity. I'm going to mash the heck out of this and just see how quickly we can kill him. If we can kill him in one phase, I will be blown away, dude. That's all I want. No, we didn't one phase him, boys. I'm a failure. Necron's handle. Okay, okay, yeah, okay. Maybe I didn't deserve one. Oh, is that a mini boss room? Oh, this is exactly what I wanted. All right, so let's put the tiger pet on real quick. Let's get this out and let's go. Okay, it's pretty annoying when you're looking at the floor. I can't lie. Okay, that was anticlimactic, but hey. Oh my days. Oh my, look at the chat, man. I just did all of that to Necron and all of my left click damage as well. I'm not gonna lie, the bloody reforge isn't doing it for me. It's not doing it for me in the slightest. The fact that I'm getting 40% attack speed off of it is kind of cringe. I'd rather take the negative defense, honestly. Bloody is not the play, chat. I thought it would be appropriate, you know, me being British and all. It's definitely not the way. Come on, give me strange. Let's see how much attack speed I have. Please be good. 100. I have 100? Do I still have my tiger pet out? Oh, I do. How much do I have without my tiger pet? I have 84. Plus, she gives me 35. I can actually put some of these back on shaded. Oh, this is so much better, chat. Wait, how many do these give? They give 4 each. I need to lose 20 attack speed. So that's 5 talismans, right? We need 5 talismans out of here, man. Now, if we put everything back in here, we should have like 64% attack speed, a ton of ferocity, and basically all of the same stats that I had before. All right, cool. I've done what I wanted to do. Basically, what I was trying to do with my talismans right there, chat, was make this sword better than the livid dagger without using the ability. Because it was obviously better with the ability, but without using it was kind of... Yeah. I mean, livid dagger just feels so nice to use because of the attack speed bonus. I actually do feel like I'm using the livid dagger again with this attack speed. Like, yeah, I am having to sacrifice a little bit of damage in talismans, but the ferocity makes up for it, honestly. The ferocity's crazy. All is dead. Everything dies, dude. Everything dies. Goodbye. Goodbye, Necron. It was nice knowing you, sir. I don't know how to describe it. I am just ruining this, dude. It's been 2 days, man, and I'm 80% of the way to Kata 29. Dude, it's so annoying playing with dungeon teams as well. It seems every single dungeons player is American. I'm like one of the few British people that actually play this, so I just get made fun of. I keep saying lever, and obviously in American English, it's lever. Like, literally, we were AFK, and someone was trying to figure out what two puzzles we were missing. I was dead. So I was just like, it's the levers, guys. They're just sitting there staring like, what's missing? What's missing? What's missing? It's the levers. And then I go, oh, it's the levers. Oh, lever, lever, lever. Okay, yeah, do the levers, guys. Lever. If you guys could change my mind and tell me so. Oh, what a bedrock chest, chat. Getting an S plus on the most difficult floor with Necron armor and a Valkyrie, and it awards me with Ultimate Jerry 3 and Bank 3. No way that is a chest you can get. Come on, dude. And Palica's in the chat simping for Jerry, as always. Nah, we stand Jerry. Not Jerry. We stand Palica. Don't take that clip out of context. I can't believe I just said that. I actually need to wash my mouth out with soap, dude. I'm doing it. Right. I can't believe I said that. I know that clip's going to get taken out of context. Everyone keeps saying, oh, Cole, Jerry. Ha ha, Jerry, funny. Everyone confuses me with all of these YouTubers that simp for Jerry, and I'm tired of it. And now everyone's going to use that clip against me. So this is going to take back everything I've said. This is going to look sus, dude. That is so foamy. I feel like I'm just deep throating Mr. Sheen, dude. What am I doing? Does that take it back? Have I earned it? Isn't that toxic? Probably. Hang on, let's read what the back says. If you get some hand wash in your eyes, just rinse well with clean water. It doesn't say anything about ingesting it, chat, so we're chilling. We're chilling. If anyone still thinks that I remotely have any interest in Jerry after I just did that, chat, you all need to send them that clip, okay? I don't want any affiliation with the man. I one-phase him every time, man. That's so hot. I'm a valuable dungeons asset now, chat. Whereas before, it was the troll YouTuber with Catacombs 24. We are now the Cata 29 Berserk, who one-phases Necron every single time, man. If you swallow the soap, there may be a pain or swelling in your throat, and on your lips or tongue, you may begin to vomit repeatedly, and you may vomit blood. Well, I don't feel any of the physical sensations, like my lips, tongue, all of that. They feel fine. What I do feel is my stomach churning. So I hope I don't end up vomiting, especially not blood. We weren't out here downing like a whole bottle or something, man. That can't be good for you. That really can't be good for you. I mean, not like it's good for you at all, but still. Ah, he's dead anyway, man. They don't even need my help. Minus 10k? Okay, okay, dude. Okay, 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 okay. Chest plates. You love to see it, man. Let's do floor 6 with the Valkyrie, actually. I want to see what this is like. It's time to try out the floor 6 boss with full floor 7 gear. Floor 7 is so much more difficult than floor 6. It's not even funny. And they made floor 6 even easier. I really, really fail to understand the logic personally. But, you know, it is what it is, dude. I love just standing AFK for nearly 2 minutes while I wait for the giants to spawn. Jesus Christ. We basically one-tapped the terracotta. Dude, I think if I put my baby Yeti on and hold the flare of truth, I literally can't die. It doesn't matter whether you go completely AFK or kill them all. The interest level at the top ticks down at the exact same rate over and over and over and over again. Let's see how quickly the regular giants die, actually. Come here, boyo! Oh yeah, teleporting is a thing, man. I'm gonna have to remember that. All right, those guys are all dead. Here we go, dude. One man, one sedan. Bruh, this is so difficult to control. I can't lie to you, chat. I can't really hit him and use the ability at the same time. Sedan, he's gone. That's it. Just one person. I can solo floor 6. Literally like a week or two ago. Floor 6, you know, I actually had to play in a decent team for it. And that's just the end of him. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed the stream. If you did, please be sure to drop a like and subscribe if you're new around here. It took me days to get my hands on this weapon. It's no secret that the contraband definitely helped. But even with all of the contraband, acquiring this was a difficult task, man. A difficult task. But we did it. We are the most OP man in Hypixel Skyblock. And the sad thing is, there's only one boss we can use it against. Please give me more in-game content, Hypixel. I crave it. I really, really do. Thank you all so much for watching. Hope you all have a great rest of your day. And peace.